donuts.
Stick out my tongue in all the... Oh, you're taking video. This is fantastic.
Victory.
I don't even... I'm ready for my close-up now. What do I say?
Wait,
there are donuts.
Gotta get off.
Video.
The
oh. I knew that.
I don't care if we're not supposed to eat these yet. One! Thank you, open. Oh my Jesus.
Yummy.
I'm looking.
Aqua.
I don't see it.
Pops up.
All right, he's on the bus. Let's go.
This is awesome.
All right, guys. So we're on our way back. Just want to say a couple words. First of all, you guys sounded incredible today. Really, really, really good.
Yeah!
So,
yeah!
We are the best.
The rehearsal, I think, really helped. I don't know if you guys feel that way. But especially props to the drum set players. You guys kept a really solid beat for everyone. So, nice job. Drumline, you guys really, really sounded good. And thanks for being flexible with your program. And we'll have to be like that tomorrow as well when we have the men play. A couple of things people said, because it's like... We're like the celebrity band, so I was literally pulled aside by almost a dozen different people. I had a band director, former band director from Stanford University, compliment the band and talk about how great we were. He specifically liked a lot of the jazz charts we did. I had four or five different fans from Vermont come up to us, and they were really impressed when I told them that, you know, the drumline was rehearsing this morning at 4:30 a.m. It was awesome. You guys did great. I had, so Vermont, different people from Vermont kept coming up to me, including the directors, and of course I told them, because they had a really good band as well, so I was telling them how great everything was, and they kept saying, they were like, oh man, you guys are so great, and you know, if only we had a football team too, and I, three different people from Vermont said that, and I was like, we don't have a football team. You don't? But you have a drum line. I'm like, yeah. Yeah, so it's a props to you guys. And I was like, yeah, this is really their only their second year as an official group, so. Yeah, pretty awesome. So, we do have exciting news. So we found out about that whole, you know, they had a guitar player. Apparently you are now allowed to bring amplified instruments, and thanks to Heather Hercision, her parents are going to be bringing a bass guitar to the game tomorrow from New Jersey for Julian and Sarah to play, so that'll be really awesome. We are heading back to the hotel now, and it's not all that far away. So hang tight. Tomorrow, I will actually send out a text message when we need to report tomorrow, but it's looking like a 12 o'clock, sometime between 12 o'clock we'll be checking out, and at 12:15 we will depart for the game. If we win tomorrow's game, then we will go back to the hotel and spend another night. So extra cheering, and you'll get $30 extra.
Unlike money.
cash money. That's the
cash
real setup.
Money.
If we lose, we load up the bus and we head back to Maryland, and we should be back by around midnight. Yeah. So, thanks again, guys.
You got the magic never fails. You got the power in your corner now. Heavy ammunition in your hands.
Tomorrow, here's what's going to go down. We're going to have the late checkout again like we had today, so it'll probably be like 11:45 checkout in the lobby.
John Becker, the Vermont head coach, on top of UMBC. His countouts are 27-26.
That's a stare down?
Yeah, that's... you know what? There are no winners in that stare down, and there really is no losers because they can't blink. Let's see if we can keep that. You know how the hawk at St. Joseph's doesn't stop?
The wings, yeah.
Maybe we can start our own tradition like they just stare at each other for 2.5 hours there. What do you think?